Mr. Thompson, the animal I think was there from the road, but I'm not sure if it was.
Yes, my daddy.
Come in. Come in. Where are they?
You oversleep.
Oh, Thank you. Thank you. All of my life.
Yeah. No, no, me. Right.
Unless
Thank you. Your second level is here.
Absolutely.
How are you doing? You okay?
And you, and
I'm over. We hold it down tonight.
So when you come down in China,
I'm going to go to the hospital. Beloved, we are gathered in this sacred hour to celebrate the life of dear Kenneth Percival Thompson. We want to thank God for his grace upon him and the family. We want to thank God that his mercies are new every morning. The supply of his grace continues to comfort us during such a time as this. So I'm going to ask us to bow for a moment of silence, and then we proceed with our beginning reflection. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Fear not, Jesus said, I am the first and the last. I'm the living one. I died, and behold, I'm alive forevermore. And I have the keys of death and of Hades. Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted. The eternal God is our refuge and strength, and underneath are the everlasting arms. Weeping may tarry for the night, but joy comes in the morning. Almighty God, we call upon you at this time. Draw near. Minister grace in this time of quiet. We ask for your strength and for your wisdom. We ask, oh God, that even as you visit, you would speak to each heart, bringing comfort and wisdom as we consider our own days. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. I want to welcome the family and indeed all the dear beloved ones who have come to comfort the family here with them at this time. May God bless you and may his comforting grace abide with you. At this time, we will together sing one of those hymns that we sing to comfort our hearts and to remind us that God is a sovereign and that his mercies continue. It is well with my soul. We all stand together and join the hymn. It's all mapped into our programs. We're in peace like a river.
We're in peace like a
Thank you. Is a forgiving Savior. And the joy we have, even in this hymn, calls our attention. It says, oh, the bliss of this glorious thought, my sin, not in part, but the whole. The idea is that when Jesus washes our sins away, he washes them all away. How comforting to know that we can stand before him our sins forgiven. He's a good and gracious Lord. At this time, we come to the reading of Scripture. The first reading is from the Old Testament, and it's Psalm 121. Psalm 121, the first reading, and somebody's going to stop. Thank you.
Greetings, everyone. Support us. Okay, my son was supposed to read, but he unfortunately couldn't make it, so I'm standing for him. He is the second and first grandson. The scripture lesson will be taken from Psalm 121, reading from 121, and it begins. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The Lord is thy keeper. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. Eighth and last, the Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from this time forth and even forevermore. Here endeth a portion of God's own word. We honor by saying, the Lord give it and the Lord take it. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
We come now to the New Testament reading. And the New Testament reading is taken from Ephesians chapter 1, verses 3 to 14. Let me call on the fire. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Reading is taken from Ephesians 1, verse 3 to 14. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. According as he had chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. Having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praises of the glory of his grace, wherein he had made us accepted in the beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin, according to the riches of his grace, wherein he had abounded toward us in all wisdom and prudence, having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he had purposed in himself, that in his dispensation of the fullness of times he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ, in whom he also trusted after that he heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also after that he believed. Yea, were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise, which is the fairness of our inheritance until the redemption of the purpose, possession unto the praise of his glory. Here ended the reading of the word.
Amen.
The Lord give it and you take it away. May your soul rest in peace, Mr. Kenneth Thompson.
Our readings do call our attention to the greatness of our God, who directs our steps. In the Old Testament reading, Psalm 121, directs our steps day and night. Psalmist asks, where does my help come from? And then the second reading in the New Testament calls our attention to the saving grace of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is Christ who came to redeem us and to pull us back into communion with God. Hallelujah. Our God reigns and watches and directs our steps, and he directs our steps to the point of bringing us to the place of redemption when we were lost in sin and shame. Blessed be the name of the Lord. At this time, we're going to go to our next hymn, How Great Thou Art. This is one of the old favorites that many of Mr. Kenneth's age and time will recall it being played on the radio, sung down at the church. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hands had made, I see the stars and I hear the roaring thunder. How great thou art. Shall we rise again?
And all my strength.
Thank you. the saints would sing when we get around the throne. How
yes.
great. It has not yet appeared. It doesn't yet enter our minds. The greatness, the majesty of God. When we get around the throne of grace and we get to observe who we've been worshiping all through the century. We'll sing the song again. In fact, the way the book of Revelation says, we'll just cry, worthy, worthy, worthy is the Lamb that was slain.
Hallelujah.
We must be ready.
Yeah.
Paul today is to get ready.
Yeah.
Jesus calls us to be prepared for that great and noble day. No need to linger in this world of sin. No need to linger in the entertainment of the flesh, to be constantly bombarded with the pulls and temptations of the devil. The Bible says, break loose. Trust Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, so that on that day when he calls you, you will be ready to go with him. This time we're going to go into the obituary. We're going to be reflecting on something of the story of history of their edit. And then there's going to be a selection from Minister Wade. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Obituary. Kenneth P. Thompson was born on July 8th, 1942, to Mabel Gray and Joshua Thompson in St. Catherine, Jamaica, West Indies, having six siblings. Ken attended Mount Nebo Primary School, and after graduation, he went on to learn a practical trade. Ken learned masonry and carpentry in his early 20s and enjoyed building and repairing anything that was broken. He immigrated to the United States in 1974 to work as a farm worker in Florida. In 1976, he married Inez Clark until 1988, when they separated. He worked as a housekeeper at the Hebrew Hospital for Chronic Sick in the Bronx, New York, location for 24 years until he retired in 2006. Ken enjoyed playing table games, playing music on his sound system, and watching action-packed movies. Ken was an independent and hardworking individual. He enjoyed treating himself to the best of everything he felt he could afford. Ken was always there to help family and friends with any project that they needed his help on. Kenneth Thompson, 78 years old, of the Bronx, New York, succumbed to his illness while enrolled at Workman's Circle Multicare Center in the Bronx, New York, on January 20th, 2021. Ken is survived by daughters Del Rose, Carletta, Claudine, and his son Desmond, sister Patrona, brothers Owen and Morris, one daughter-in-law, six grandchildren, nieces, nephews, cousins, and extended family. KPT, my Uncle Ken. Rest in peace. Thank you.
I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, cause I wanna see my dealer someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back, cause I won't see my dealer someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't hurt back, cause I wanna see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't hurt back, cause I wanna see my Jesus someday.
And I won't turn back, cause I
Commit, not turning back, going to see my Jesus someday. Thank you, Minister Wayne, for the rendering of the song in the spirit. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, Mr. Thompson's son, Desmond, is going to render a poem, after which we're going to have the floor open for a few moments for some tributes of family and friends. Are going to be invited to come and share a few tributes with us. God bless you. Come, Brother Best.
Good morning to all.
Good morning.
And thanks for being here. Don't weep at my grave, for I am not there. I have a date with a butterfly to dance in the air. I'll be singing in the sunshine, wild and free, playing tag with the wind while I'm waiting for thee. Our joys will be greater. Our love will be deeper. Our lives will be fuller because we shared it. Your moment. Where I have gone, I am not so small. My soul is as wide as the world is tall. I have gone to answer the call of all the one who takes care of us all. Wherever you look, you will find me there. In the heart of a rose, in the heart of a bird, on butterflies, wings, on wings of my home. To you, I'm gone. But I'm never alone. I'm I'm not going to take much time. Few more folks might want to say something, but the last time I saw my dad alive was December 9th. Due to the situation with COVID, He was at the Whitman Circle. There was restricted visitation. And I even went and got COVID tested twice. Because I required that, that should be one requirement of the visit. And for some unknown reason, both times I took the test, he went into the hospital the following day. So going to visit in the hospital was the only thing that I could actually see him at that time. The last time when I saw him, I was able to give him a shake. And even though sometimes I do stop or hit me out or critique me and, you know, how well did I do it? But he just like that. But at least he said, you know, oh, you did a good job. So if there's anything else, as I said to you last night, we tried our best. We did the best of our ability to make sure that, you know, he was comfortable to the best that we could afford. And he chose to stop fighting. The night before he passed away, the nurse told us that she was trying to let him, you know, see if he would eat anything at all, but he shut down and stopped eating. I guess it was quite a sign to us that he wasn't going to fight anymore. So we love him. We know that, you know, he did his best for us, and we tried to do it in return. I just want to thank you all for being here today and full support of us. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, being the first rose from Phyllis and Kenneth Garden, I love you, Daddy. And I miss you. May your soul rest in peace. Amen.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
2 minutes is not enough to express what we feel about Mr. Kenny. He was such a sweet and loving person. He was that kind of person who would just try to do everything. He would give you a chance to do anything. He was so helpful sometimes, like on the streets, and a breakdown and a call him. You'd be the first to get there before the record truck. You would always love kids, always cherish kids. Everybody, so Ken was like a father. I didn't actually grow up with my father. He made me feel like everything that I need to know or that experience was what I needed. Mr. Ken, in my opinion, he's sleeping. He's sleeping. I will always, always remember his kindness to our family and my extended family. Mr. Ken, if today I didn't say something, I would not peace it myself. And I just wanted to know, I always tell you that I'm not gonna wait until you're gone. I'm always gonna express what I feel. I always tell him why I appreciate everything you do for myself and for my kids. And, you know, I always tell him, you know, I love you, God. I don't wanna wait until you're gone. And today I would just say, there's so much things to remind me of Saken. If we look around, there's something to remind me. And today, I just want to say, you will forever in wrath. Sleep in peace again.
Hello again, everyone. I'm standing here for the second time. I'm standing now on behalf of my daughter, my father first grandchild. She sent up for me. It would have been selfish to ask you to stick around for longer days when you were in so much pain and withering away. It's bittersweet without you around. The suffering that challenged you in your last days, you were not that independent man anymore. You hated depending on others for sure. The Lord give it and you take it, therefore. I will pray for your soul to make your resurrection sure. I want to see you again after I leave this temporary life. Just to ride on your luck once again, like a child. Sleep on the grounds. You're gone too soon. This is from my daughter Cassandra. So unfortunately, she would not be here. I came here not very long, so I did not really get to spend a lot of time with him. But I thank God for the few, for the little time I get with him, like, because I live in New Jersey, so, and then because of COVID, I really didn't get to be around him much. But the last time I saw him was in November, and he was suffering. He was in pain. So at this moment, I think God knows best. He gave life on the day. So, and then again, I think God, it goes away that it was really a day children to bury their parents. Unfortunately, a lot of parents bury their children. So, in spite of this bittersweet moment, I want to thank God for his life. He has lived over the 3 score. That God has given. So I just want to thank God for keeping us thus far and for everything else we do. He knows best. So my brother and sister that are here, let's just be strong and just let us live a life that we will be seeing our Father again. That's all I have to say.
Good morning, everyone. I come to know Kenneth Thompson for over 24 years, and we have been living together for 20 years. We live in a two-family house, but it never felt like that. Our door is always open. It's never locked. He comes up whenever he wants to. He does whatever he wants to, because with Kenneth, you know, whatever you're doing, he's always there to tell you, this is not how it does. This is how you do it. Always there to correct us. We share so many things together. Holidays, Christmas, Thanksgiving, regardless of him sharing it with his family, he knows he has to share it with us too. He can't be just for his immediate family. He has a second family home. So we always do everything together. We do family trips together. He's a part of his road trips. Everything we do together. And the last time I went to see him was 3 days before he passed. He passed on the Wednesday and I saw him on the Sunday. And I was there. Marcia told me that he wasn't talking, but when I went there, he was actually talking a little, not what I expected. But we talk and, you know, I said to him, the last thing I remember telling him, I said to him, I love you. And he said, yeah. And I left him there. And I was surprised when Marcia told me that he passed away. I truly will always remember Kenny Man for us, because my son grew up calling him Kenny Man. And that name My daughter is now 16, my son is 20 plus, and these kids grow with him in the same house. We're a whole family. Kenny is a family to us, and we'll truly miss you, Kenny, man. May your soul rest in peace, and you will go forever being our daughter.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi. I want to take a few minutes to say a few words on my father's behalf, Owen, and my sisters. We knew Uncle Ken since we were very small. When he would come back to Jamaica and he would visit us and he would bring us, you know, the things we would typically look forward to from a family member who lived there and visit. One of the things I really enjoyed about him, and one of the things I used to remember, was when I used to talk to him about, you know, how cold it gets here and all the things he would do here. If I remember correctly, he was a plumber and he would come down. And a lot of times he would come on vacation and visit Jamaica. That time his dad was still alive, Mr. Joshua Thompson. And he would come to Jamaica and work on his vacation, just to ensure that things were, just to ensure that he left things better than he saw it when he came. You know, I have very fond memories of him, very, very fond memories. Very fond memories of him and my dad going at it was the funniest thing, these two guys. But at the end of the day, you know, it's a circle of life. We're here. You know, somebody once told me that if you ever look on somebody's headstone, if you ever get the chance to visit a cemetery, you'll see the day they were born and the day they're passed. And that small little space in between is the time you have here to spend with your family and your friends. You know, it's very important for us never to forget the things that are truly important. You know, I'm going to assume that if he had another opportunity to tell us, he would want us to remember in his best days. Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. At this time, we're going to have a rendition. Tadisha, musical selection. And we appreciate that. And then Minister Wade would do another item. And I'll take a few minutes to share a few gospel thoughts here. Thank you.
Acceptance. Today I accept. He's not over here. My most fond memories of him was in 2015. And I said, I have no more father. He said, no, we still have me. What about me? And I said, yes, you're right. You know, I miss the days gone by eating ice cream, great nuts. And I'd ask him, where's the cone? He said, you didn't bring none. And I would start bringing ice cream, and I'll bring him cone. And we'd eat ice cream and cone. And he'd be watching 5 TVs all making noise. MacGyver, Titanic, wrestling. And I'm like, how do you see all this? He's like, read my company. Don't touch them. You know, and he was like, talk about Titanic. He's not going to take no more cruise. You know, so we'd have some good times. and to the Prince family, yes. All he talks about with you guys. Everything we tell him, he's like, I gotta talk to Betty Boo. Sorry, I gotta go find out from Betty. Everything is what Betty said. No matter what we tell him, he gotta get a confirmation from you. So we thank you for extending, you know, your home to him and where he felt comfortable, like home. And I hope that he found peace and he's no longer in the pain.
Mm-hmm.
The last few weeks I visited him, I was on vacation. And he told me, make sure when you get my age, I was gonna do, let me get any sickness. And I said, I don't know what God had in store for me, but I hope not. But you're suffering. And he said, yes, I am. And I said, I will do find comfort. And he said, I don't know if I find comfort with me not pain. You know, but it is what it is. My sibling, my sister. I know those 3 months divided. We were back and forth off from work with him to the doctor. Some days it wasn't easy. But he's no longer here no more. I hope that you remember those good things. God gives life. He takes it away. He is the potter, and I am the clay. When I view the lesson said and cross over the sea, I hear the saints of angels singing. On a homecoming day. Oh, what a sunrise it's going to be. Yes, it will lose its sting, and the grave its victory. Oh, a silence will be broken, and the storm clouds roll away. I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming day. Time will come for the last goodbye. Is a smile, new tears dim the eyes that will take hold. But only to sleep in the arms of a Savior so sweet. Oh, oh, what a sunrise it's going to be. Yes, that's will lose its day, and the grave its victory. Oh, what silence will be broken, and the storm clouds rolls away. I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming day. Say, time will come for the last goodbye.
smile, no tears in the eyes that will take hold, but only to sleep in the arms of a Savior so sweet. Oh, oh, at sunrise, it's going to be. Yet then, we'll lose its day. The great victory will be broken and the storm cloud grows away. I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming. The silence, oh, the silence will be broken and the storm clouds rolls away. Did I hear the saints of angels singing on a homecoming? Thank you.
It is so sweet to cheer us. Just to take my in word, just to rest upon him, just to know the same. Jesus, Jesus, how I trust you, how I do you all well. Jesus, oh, for grace. Oh, what do you do when you come on the see the light is never enough. Oh, what do you say when your heart has been broken? You're all alone. Tell me, what do you get when you're giving your all? Seems like it's never been done. Well, you just stand when there's nothing left to do, you just stand and watch the Lord see you. After you've done all you can, you just stand and show me not entangled with the bondage of your past. You just stand. Have it God's got a purpose. Yes, God's got a plan. Tell me, what do you do when you've done all you can?
Mercies are everlasting, even as we ponder and reflect on the demands on us to be faithful and be faithful, and after we've done all we can, just to wait and hear him say, well done, good and faithful servant. Hallelujah. I want to ask you if you have your devices, just one verse of scripture. It comes from the Old Testament, and it's Psalm 90. Psalm 90 in the Old Testament, and verse 12. A verse we are rather very familiar with, but sometimes we don't unpack it and to chew on its rich nourishment. And it says here, teach us, Lord, to number our days, that we may present to you a heart of wisdom. Teach us, Lord, to number our days, that we may present to you a heart of wisdom. Pray with me for a moment, Lord. Sovereign Master, we, even in the middle of this celebration of life of Kenneth Percival Thompson, we pause to reflect on the authority of your word and the spirit who speaks from your word. Draw near and speak to us, oh God, in this moment. You have been ministering and speaking, Lord. Again, we tie up this service. Speak to us, oh God, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Psalm 90 is rich. It was written by Moses. And Moses was grappling with death. We are living in a day, an age when there is a lot of death. Many of us can remember in the years gone by, we went to a funeral now and then. Mm-hmm. Oh, but now it's pandemic. Yeah. All across the world, from coast to coast and around the world, we are all dealing with the issue of death and dying. Oh, I got to know Minister Wade. We come down here often because we are dealing with this matter of people exiting and moving on to the next stage in preparation for answering to God for what he called them to do in this life. Death. It's in this earth, the final statement, the line drawn in the sand. You don't go another step. He calls you out of this realm to give an account of the deeds done in your body, whether they be good or evil. God is like that. He is the sovereign judge. And when he sent us into this life, he sent us with gifts and talents. He sent us with potential, and he called us to take them and work with them until he calls us out to give an account. Moses, in this psalm, had that to deal with. It was just like a pandemic for Moses in Psalm 90. And it happened because God told the children of Israel, I'm going to bring you through the Red Sea in miraculous fashion. In fact, through the wilderness, you're going to have the clouds to lead you by day and the pillar of fire by night. But it is to take you into the promised land. You've been asking for this promised land. You've been praying. The prophet spoke about the promised land. It's time now. I'm going to take you into the promised land. You see, God always fulfills his word. He completes his promise. And God has now taken them and had them ready to go into the promised land. God said, go in. But the people said, we're afraid. God said, go in. And the people said, let's examine this. They sent in 12 spies. And the spies went in to assess. And they came back and they gave a report. 10 of them said, it's impossible. We are grasshoppers. Those people are giants. 2 of them said, oh, we can do it. Let's do it. If God said we can do it, let's do it. It's amazing how many just only few people are prepared to follow God according to his word. Well, God said, if you all refuse to go into the land, I'm going to speak words of death. Every one of you who saw the miracle and saw the Red Sea great miracle, and you did not go in, God said, you're going to die in the wilderness. And that's where we meet Moses this morning. The people would die every day, death and dying, death and dying. And Moses had to bury them. They were dying across the land, all through the wilderness, funeral after funeral after funeral. They were just exiting. And Moses got to that point where it grabbed him and he wrote a poem. He sat down to write a poem, grappling with what the issues were. And as he wrote, he talked about God's great eternity. He said, before the mountains were born, before you ever gave birth to the earth, you were God. Yeah. He said, then you created us, and we looked at us, we rise early like the grass in the morning, and by evening, we are withered. Yeah. You know, there was a time I used to look so good. My wife said, you didn't even have a tummy. Look at you now. Tummy over my belly, covering up, like, you know. I lost 1 or 2 teeth and I wear glasses. By evening, I start to wither. I walk with a little pain in my hip. This is what Moses is talking about. When God sends us into the life, we are fresh. We are strong, we have potential, we want to win the world. And then by evening time, we get weak, I lose my hair. I'm beginning to, sometimes I'll be laying somewhere like this. I'm not afraid because God dealt with me. You got to reckon. There's a time coming when we come. We have to lie down. We work no more. Moses was watching this happen over and over. And as he wrote the poem, he broke into prayer. Hear his prayer. Teach us, Lord, to number our days, that we present to you a life that was lived wisely, wise life. Teach us, Lord. Oh God, we need you to speak to us about the life you gave us to live. This was a moving prayer. It became a sermon. People began to deal with the call of God to live wisely. In fact, the scriptures tell us that young men are strong. It calls young people. It says, I call you because you're strong, young people. You have the alertness of mind. Take your life and give it to Jesus. Wise, strong, intelligent. You can speak, you can think, you can accomplish. Give it to Jesus. Teach us, Lord, to number our days. The word number is a mathematical word. It means do an assessment on that. It's the idea of going into the warehouse and seeing what's missing and what you have. If you have this, you don't need to order anymore. But if you don't have, you need to order certain things into your warehouse. Your life is a warehouse. There are things that are missing. One of the things for many people is Jesus Christ. Many people don't have Jesus Christ. They have some religion. They have some songs. They have some church. They have some civility. They have some good behavior, but they don't have Jesus. There are many people who they have wealth. They have prosperity. They have good health. They have a good job. They do well, but they don't have Jesus. My friend, if you ask me, what is Mr. Ken saying to us? He speaks from silence and he speaks with clarity. You sure have Jesus. Teach us, Lord, to number our days. Oh God, how much time I have left? Do I have Jesus? Am I washed in the blood of Jesus? Am I indwelt by the Holy Spirit? Do I know Jesus? Do I have my name written in the book? This is the import of Moses' psalm and his commission and his prayer. Teach us, Lord, to number our days. Oh, my friend, it resonates with Jesus Christ. For when he came and gave his life on the cross, this is what he was doing. He was extending his hands. He was saying, come to me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, I will give you rest. This is what John 3:16 means. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. It's a call to make sure it is well with your soul. It's a call to make sure that you have trusted Jesus Christ, that you have repented of sin, that you have turned around, and that you are now seeking to walk the path of holiness. Oh, my friend, what an opportunity that Mr. Kenneth leaves us, an opportunity to reflect whenever there is this period and season in life. It is time to take account. It is time to do the check-in. Am I right with God? Is my name in the book of life? Teach me, Lord, to number my days that the rest of time I have. You see, in this psalm, it is there we learn Moses saying, hey, we have a free score until, and if you destroy, we get a little more. And it is in this psalm we walk away saying that, but well, we have 70 years and some more if you strengthen. And Moses gave us a sort of benchmark, and he says, check how much more time you have by the benchmark in this psalm. How close are you to 70? How much more beyond 70 you have lived? He's saying, listen, my friend, check your life. There is coming a day when it will be cut off. See what's missing. Bring your life up to date with Jesus Christ as your Lord. Let us pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh God, we are living in the lesson this moment. Teach us, Lord. Oh, Lord. A friend of God spoke to your heart, and you want to pray that you can do that. Lord Jesus, come into my heart. Forgive me my sin. Change, Lord. I repent of my sin, Lord. I want to walk now with you. I want to be born again, Lord Jesus. Change, Lord. Correct my life, Lord. Oh God, I see that I have a lot of good stuff, but I'm missing being born again. Oh Lord. Oh Lord. I need to trust you. I thank you. Oh God, I want to pray for this dear family. The love they have for Dad. The love they have for each other, Lord Jesus. I pray that you would comfort them. That you would walk with them, you would put some hand holding, that they know that they're not alone, and that the sovereign master is watching over their every step. Lord, we pray that you heal them from any diseases. Oh, we pray that you provide their daily bread, that all would be well. We pray that no curse will fall upon them, that, oh God, they would live in the light of your majesty and be blessed of the Lord. Oh God, we pray that you defend them against the wiles of the devil and the attack of the enemy. Oh God, we pray that the name of Jesus would be exalted in this family. Oh, we bless you. Oh, we praise you. Walk with them. Have mercy on them, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, the manager is going to come. I'll just do the benediction now. Let's just bow for the benediction. Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us now and forever. All God's people said,
Amen. This concludes the service of celebration of life for your beloved Kenneth Percival Thompson. I'd first like to take this opportunity to thank Reverend Dr. Russell McLeod, along with the entire Olivet Gospel Church family. Certainly grateful for Minister of Music, Minister Kevin Wade, those participating virtually, and to every one of you for whatever role you may have played or you may be playing in making this time of transition somewhat easier for the family. To the family, once again, on behalf of Eternity Funeral Services, we continue to encourage you. Friends, Mr. Thompson will be laid to rest in the Kensico Cemetery in accordance with his family's wishes. If you are going to be a part of our funeral procession, I ask that once you exit the chapel, you will retrieve a funeral sticker right by the hand sanitizer. You'll place these stickers in your rear windows. They will allow other motorists to realize that you're part of a funeral procession. I'm also going to ask you to place your headlights and hazard lights on so we may proceed in a safe manner. At this time, we're going to allow the final opportunity for healing. I'm going to ask that you carefully follow the instructions of Mr. Martinez standing in the rear. You will view and make the chat. Take care of yourselves and each other.
1 minute. So as you guys know, we have to follow CDC guidelines. We'll be having a drive-by repast. So whether you're online live streaming, feel free to drive out. We have food and refreshment home. We have money short, everything. You know, we're Jamaican, so we're going to make sure it turned up, right? So we're going to make sure to treat you guys. And thank you all for supporting us. So if you're online, live streaming, or you're nearby, feel free. Ask by. I can be faster. And pick up your trays. We know it's CDC guidelines. It's late summer, so... Oh, I'm going to give the address. Sorry. We can't do it outside. It's cold. If it's a summer, we set up a tent. You guys come. Feel free. The address is 1237 East 223rd Street, Bronx, New York, 10466. Miles number 718-405-2281, just in case you want to pause, see if we get back home. But feel free to pick up your refreshment. He would like that. He likes to have his great food. So I made sure I bleached last night to make sure you guys have a warm meal, some garnish water soup to eat and have a good time. And as we send him off in one good piece. Thank you. I'll repeat the address again. It's 1237 East 223rd Street, Bronx, New York, 10466. That was number 718-405-2281. My cell is 718-593-9883 to check to see if we get back home. But feel free, it'll be all day, and that's including you, the Prince family. Thank you. Thank you.
No, because of the mask.